Hello children, I hope you have gone through the first part of the chapter, that is nutrition in plants. If you have gone through the video, then in the previous class you have studied about how the green plants, how the plants prepare their own food. That is nothing but what? The process of photosynthesis, which is called as food making process. So students, you have seen that the green leaves in the plants, they prepare their own food with the help of chlorophyll. Apart from the leaves which are not green in color, other than green color, they also prepare their own food. So this is what you have seen in the previous class. But children, do you know there are some plants who have green stem, who have green branches? So those green stem, those green branches, they also contain chlorophyll. They also prepare their own food. They also carry out the process of photosynthesis. For example, if you see, then the desert plants, for example, cactus. So cactus also prepares its own food. It has green stem with the help of which it prepares its own food and carries out photosynthesis process. So children, we can form an equation. That is, during the process of photosynthesis, the cells of the leaves, they contain chlorophyll. In the presence of sunlight, the carbon dioxide and water, they combine to form carbohydrates. And thus, the oxygen is released. That is, CO2 plus H2O in presence of sunlight, in presence of chlorophyll, they give us carbohydrates plus oxygen. So during this process, oxygen is released, which is inhaled by the human beings. Yes, children? So carbohydrates, it ultimately gets converted into starch. Starch is nothing but what? A kind of carbohydrate. That is, the starch gives, or the starch tells the presence of chlorophyll. It allows the occurrence of photosynthesis process. So this is what you have seen in the previous class. So I mentioned cells, isn't it? So what are cells, children? Yes, you will learn about cells in detail in your class 9th. But we will have a brief idea, because the cells of the leaves, they contain what? Chlorophyll. And they prepare the food with the help of these cells. So cells means what? Have you seen the buildings? So buildings are made up of what? They are made up of bricks. So brick is a unit which makes up the wall, which makes up the building. Similarly, living organisms is made up of tiny units, little room-like structures. They are called as what? Cells. The cell again has a thin outermost covering. That outermost covering is called as what? Cell membrane or cell wall. You can see those cells under microscope. If you take any leaf section and if you take a temporary mounting under the microscope, then you will observe the tiny room-like structures. They are called as cells. It contains a thin outermost covering that is called as what? Cell membrane. Further, the cells have distinct centrally located dark body, that is nothing but what? Nucleus. And the nucleus is surrounded by some jelly-like structure, jelly-like substance that is called as what? Cytoplasm. So this cytoplasm is very, very important for the process of photosynthesis. It contains chlorophyll, because of which the plants capture sunlight and they prepare their own food, on which the human beings are dependent. Yes, children, are you clear about it? Yes. So plants prepare their food with the help of the process of what? Photosynthesis.